This segment demonstrates some preliminary results in real-time robot visual servoing. A robot end-mounted camera is used to position the robot arm in a plane orthogonal to the camera axis, such that the object of interest is centered in the camera's field of view. The system is unusual in that it has no trajectory generator. Instead, a feedback loop, closed visually, is used to control the robot's position. There are two major subsystems involved in this experiment. The system looks at the scene via a robot end effector mounted camera. Although a stereo camera configuration is shown, the output of only one camera is utilized. The raw video processing, such as filtering and thresholding, is performed by DataCube image processing modules, which process grayscale video at 10 millipixels per second. The most important part of the system is a binary image processing board set that performs single-pass connectivity and generates parameters such as 0 to second moments, perimeter and bounding box for all connected regions in the scene at video rates. Parameters are computed in parallel by 8 arithmetic units, implemented in custom gate arrays, and kept in onboard dual-port memory for host access. Processing time is independent of scene complexity. The vision processing software runs on a Sun 3260 computer connected to the video processing modules. It examines all detected regions and determines which is the target to be tracked. It issues appropriate velocity commands to the robot control subsystem to center the target in the camera's field of view. The robot control runs on a DEC Microvax 2 connected to a Unimate robot controller. It accepts robot Cartesian velocity commands over the network and implements a resolved rate motion control algorithm. Robot joint angle commands are sent every 14 or 28 milliseconds. The dominant dynamic effect in the closed loop system is delay, which is contributed by the raster scan nature of the sensor, video processing delay, communications, and robot finite motion time. A simple lead lag compensator is used to stabilize the closed loop system. This increases the speed of response at the expense of additional overshoot.
This is a general view of the laboratory facilities used to support the experimental work. The robot is Unimate Puma 560 with an end effector mounted camera. The robot is driven by the standard Unimate control box, but the valve computer has been disconnected and replaced by an interface to a VME bus system. A Motorola 68030 processor board is responsible for robot control and image feature processing. The machine vision system is built from DataCube pipelined image processing modules, and these perform digitization, thresholding, median filtering, and overlay graphic storage. Binary image is performed by a specialized module, which makes region data available to the host processor via the VME bus. The whole machine vision system is a pixel pipeline, and there is no intermediate image storage, since that would increase overall latency. The camera image with overlaid diagnostic information is displayed on a color monitor. The controller is connected to the laboratory Ethernet, and this allows program development, debugging, and control from a networked workstation computer. A camera-mounted pulsed LED strobe system has been developed, which provides a more compact and cooler alternative to standard studio floodlamp illumination. The light pulses are synchronized with the camera's electronic shutter, and the LED system only illuminates objects in the camera's field of view.
High-performance robot visual servoing requires a vision system with a high sample rate and low latency. In the system shown here, we use only visually sensed position error feedback and make no use of prediction or camera calibration data. Our vision system can analyze all objects in the field of view at video field rate, 50 Hz. A key to this approach is a specialized pipeline processing unit that extracts image features directly from the video signal. By processing the video signal on the fly, that is, without buffering, we can reduce image processing delay to the minimum possible. However, delay due to serial pixel transport remains a dominant dynamic characteristic. Closed-loop performance is measured by tracking an optical square wave excitation. In these experiments, a simple control law is used. The Cartesian velocity of the camera is proportional to visually sensed position error. Measurements indicate a settling time of 200 milliseconds or 10 sampling intervals. The view, as seen by the camera, is shown on the monitor along with other operational status. Two-dimensional control is a simple extension involving two independent Cartesian control loops. An application such as seam tracking can be implemented by a hybrid strategy where vertical motion is pre-programmed and horizontal motion is controlled visually. By itself, a single camera view cannot give direct depth information, but camera motion can be exploited. One approach is to use fixation. If the camera is rotated slightly, the system perceives translational motion whose magnitude is related to distance. A correctional translation, so as to keep the object centered in the field of view, results in motion through an arc. That arc is centered upon the object, and the radius is equal to the object distance.
Robot visual servo systems are commonly based on feedback of position error as sensed by the camera. This allows reasonable performance as shown in these step response experiments. However, for challenging applications, in particular tracking a target with unknown motion, a following error or lag is evident. To achieve improved control performance, it is not feasible to simply increase the loop gain. This leads to instability, so a different control approach is required. The following segments show a new visual servoing controller which is based on target velocity feed forward. The last two axes of a Puma robot act as a pan-tilt camera head, which moves so as to keep the target object centered in the field of view. Here, the robot is seen tracking a target on a turntable, which results in a challenging acceleration profile. The velocity estimator used makes no assumptions about the target's acceleration and can cope with stop-start and reversing motion. From the robot's point of view, the scene looks like this. Note the apparent change in size of the target as its distance varies. The target's velocity is not directly measurable, but is estimated from target position measurements. These are based on the target's image plane position and the camera orientation, which is derived from joint angle encoders. Translational motion of the robot's wrist, introduced by driving the first four joints, results in a disturbance which the controller can reject. The same controller can be used for more dynamically challenging tracking applications. In this example, a ping-pong ball is thrown across the robot's field of view. What we are seeing is a slow-motion replay of the robot's eye view. For the first few frames, the robot is not moving and the ball moves quickly across the scene. This delay is required for the controller's velocity estimates to converge. Once the robot starts to move, the apparent velocity of the ball is reduced and eventually reversed. Finally, the ball moves into a gloomy corner of the lab and is lost from sight. The whole episode is over in less than 700 milliseconds.
This is the experiment used to test axis control for high-speed motion of joint 1 with a peak end effective velocity of 2 meters per second. The control shown here is single-axis computed torque, but camera-based endpoint feedback can be used to control the oscillation, which is evident here. In this experiment, the system attempts to keep the camera above the combined center of the two markers by controlling camera motion in the X, Y, and Z directions. Motion in the plane parallel to the turntable is based on estimated target velocity feed forward, while camera height control is based on the apparent distance between the two markers. The The first three axes of the robot are under computer torque control.